Hello friends, myself Muthu Rajan. In the last video we discussed about like how we can pass the values from request like in this view to our response page. Okay, in this video what I am going to do is I am going to explain about like how we can create header, footer and content page, as well as we are going to see how we are create a Jinja tag. Okay, so those things we are going to discuss now. And so before starting our session, if you didn't subscribe my channel, please subscribe and like my video and please comment to improve myself. Okay guys. Okay, now in the last video here, you remember, I think we passed the value from here to there. Now what I am going to do is I am going to create header footer. Basically, why we need to create a header footer, man? Like the main reason for this is like we can reuse the code. For example, in one new file for testing purpose. Okay, so for example, here one header is there and here one footer is there. If you have any content, we will reuse the code. For example, in the entire HTML page, for example, if you are using about us, if you are having about us, or if you are having any contact page, for everything we are going to use this same header and this same footer. So we can reuse the code, right? So that is the main use of this concept. We will see now like how we can create that. Okay, now I already created one HTML page, right? We will go there. What I am going to do is I am going to create another file which is called header. Okay, so Control Shift S, which will create a file inside the same folder. Okay, so now what I am going to do is I am going to create header file. So it is created inside that particular template. Okay, now so this is actually one shortcut for creating this. I will create a separate video for VS Code shortcuts. Okay, so now I am just going to change the title name as Solver Geeks. Okay, so now I created the page. Actually, this tag is useful for posting or sending anything. It's a form. Okay, form tag. Here we need to give the input tags. Okay, so I am creating two text box now. Two text box and one submit button. Actually, what I am going to do is I am going to create one mini calculator. Okay, so I created a tag called mini calculator. So here the name is first number, and here the name is second number. Okay, and finally we are giving submit button. So if we give a value, it will reflect over there. So I am giving add. So now we created a form now. So it's almost done. What you need to do is you need to create one. This is the entire page. Now I said this is a header page, right? So no need to give these informations. What you need to do is you need to remove this. Like I am going to take this one. Okay, and I am creating another page, that is add.html. So here I am going to paste it, and this is actually a Jinja tag, like same like this one, I already told you how we can create this one. This is for passing the dynamic value, right? So this is also Jinja tag, but here we can call the internal inbuilt functions. Okay, for example, I'm going to use include. Here I'm going to give header.html. Okay, I gave already. Now, so this is the header file, right? So here what you need to do is you need to put block as content. Okay, now we created that. Here what you need to do is you need to end the block. So we open and we created a block. Now here what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the same thing. And here I'm going to end the block. So the main use of this is, like, here we included the header file, so these content will get loaded automatically, and this content will load here, okay, which we are passing there. Like here we are giving this one, right? This will come here, and finally we need a footer, right? Footer one. Okay, for creating a footer, I am creating another small tag called h4. I am a footer. Okay, I created this one. So from here to here, I am removing and I am creating another file called footer. And what I am going to do is I am going to remove this one and I am pasting this. And in our addition file, at last I am calling this one. footer.html. Okay, we connected now. So three things. First one is header, footer, and the content we need to load. Okay, we created everything. So now we need to display this particular add page. Okay, for that what I am going to do is I am going to create a path in e-commerce, because we already, this is a subfolder, we already created a main, we already connected with main folder. So I am creating a path here. So no need to, don't forget this comma, because last time we faced the error, right? Okay, so I am going to create another path called add. Okay, in view dot index comma name. So actually it's a HTML page, we can say add HTML. Okay, or display calculator, kind of like we can give any name. So whatever you want you can give, it should be small, right? Then only we can easily find that. So I am giving add care. Okay, I am giving the same name here as well. So we created a path now. So it will go to views. In views it will find the function called add care. Okay, I am saving now. I am going to create this in view. Okay, I am not going to disturb this index. I am creating another function called addCare, and we need to give the request. I already said, right, for mentioning this particular function belongs to this particular file, like this one. Okay, so you need to give the request, and inside that I am going to return render of request comma add.html. If you are having more files, we need to give subfolder. Right now for testing purpose I am just directly giving this one. Okay, so I am not going to pass any dynamic value, so I am just saving now, and I am going to load here in e-commerce, I'm going to create, I'm going to call add calc. See, one mini calculator created. So basically I used to prefer Bootstrap for decorating your HTML files, like, okay. So if you want, you can use, for example, here I'm saving this and I'm going to paste in our base file, that is in header. I'm going to paste this. So I pasted now. Now I'm going here. So now I added that one, but some changes happen, but it is not a big change. So you need to know about some HTML tags, then only you will get understand. Okay, for example, here you need to give for text box, you need to give form control, and here I am going to give button. Okay, button. So I created now. So you can use the same if you want. For testing, for learning purpose, I'm not going to show all the things. I'm showing the basic classes. Okay. So this is a container. Inside that, I created these things. And if you want, you can use the row also. I'm just giving form group. So we created now. So if we load this one, see, it is changed now. Okay, so like this you can decorate yourself. So for example, if you want label also, we can give. For time being, I am giving placeholder called first number, and in the same way I am giving the last number also. Sorry, second number. Now I refresh the page, it will show here. Okay, we can directly give and we can post it. Basically, if you are if you not mention any method here, for actually we need to give a method and we need to mention it. If you are not mentioning anything, it will automatically assume as get method. Okay, for example, I am giving 1 and 2 and I am not giving any action, so it will not go to anywhere. It will directly load here. So it is saying first number contain 1, second number contain 2. Okay, it is loading itself. Okay, because of we didn't mention any action here. So I am creating an action called result. So now I created this result now. So first I am going to create the URL. So path, the name called result. If any name called result, I need to go to view and I need to call that particular function called result, and the name equal to root name equal to result. Okay, I created now. So in HTML, like, we already created this HTML, right? For result, I am going to create another one. So I am creating result in the same folder. Okay, in result we are not going to show these things. Okay, for time being I'm going to give any label or bold, whatever you want. I'm just going to display the answer, which is result. I'm going to pass result here. Okay. If you notice this one, see it is changed, the color is changing, right? See, this one is white, this one is some blue kind of. So the reason is the ginger tag is getting identified. Why? Because we already added the extension. In the last video I explained you how we need to add that extension. Okay, please watch the video, then only you will understand much better. Okay, next I am going to create the result function. So I'm creating a function called result with request, and inside that I'm going to create one variable called res. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the response. Okay, for that we need to use request dot get. Inside that I'm going to give first name. We can say this is num1 num2 because we are taking two numbers, right? So actually it's a number. Okay, the second number. So we took two numbers. So this indentation is very important. You need to give a proper space, otherwise it will return error. Okay, now finally I'm going to pass the result called render of, I'm going to call the request, I'm going to call result dot html. Okay, finally what I'm going to do is I'm going to add these two things. So for adding, I'm creating res equal to num1 plus num2. Basically I used to explain this, like, don't give this kind of name. We need to give a proper name, because if another developer is reading your code, or if you are coming after long back, you are coming to this page, that time you will get confused. So you need to give a proper name, then only you can understand much better. Okay, so I added these two numbers here and I am going to display here now. So I already said we need to pass like an object. So I am going to pass like this. So I created now. Okay, so the name is result. Now I am going here. Now I am giving 4, 5. See, it's added now. So 45 it is showing. Here it is showing footer. But I want to know like whether a header is loaded or not. So I am going to create one name called header. For same name, header. Okay. So I created a header now. See, it is showing header also. But did you notice it is an addition function, but it is showing 45, which means it is concatenating both the things. But I want addition function. For doing that, what we need to do is we need to convert this. I already said if you use input, which will get the information, which will get the string, right? Basically, if user is fetching, trying to give any value, that time it will fetch the information as a string. So what we used to do is we need to convert this into integer. Okay, I already explained to you how we can do this. So same here also, when you are getting the information from user, it will give you as a string. So what you need to do is you need to convert this as integer, then only you can do the addition operation. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add the same process now. I'm giving 3, I'm giving 2. See, it is 5. So we passed 2 and 3. So you can think like, if the information is visible, the hackers or any other person will get to know what exactly they are doing. So for that, what we need to do is we need to change that. I'll explain you another concept. Basically, while creating API, there are 3 conditions we need to check. Like that should be a proper method. We need to choose a proper method, and we need to pass the information in JSON format, because it is much better understandable by any people. Okay, and we need to create a proper URL name. Okay, then only the another developer will get understand much better. Okay, so in method there are so many methods we have, but I am going to explain few things. First one is get, second one is post, third one is put, fourth one is patch, fifth one is delete. So there are 5 important functions we need to consider while passing a API. So I already said API is a application programming interface which will connect 2 different language applications. Okay. In get we need to note one point, that is we can pass limited information. We cannot pass that much of information. So we can pass only limited information. So that is the main point. So it is having limited data, and here you can pass whatever data you want. So there is no limit. Okay, that is the main difference between get and post. So basically we use get for fetching the information, post for adding the which means storing the information, because it is a hidden information, right? So that is for storing, and this is for actually update. Sorry, it's patch, it's a put, right? So put is useful for updating any information in database, and this patch is for partial update. Okay, if you want to update any one particular value, for example here you can update any full rows. Okay, that time you can use this one, and this patch is for updating any one particular value in the row. Okay, that time you can use this patch. This is the name itself, we will understand like what exactly it is useful. So it will delete the information. Okay, that's it. So we need to consider these 5 information while creating an API. Okay, so now what I am going to do is I am going to change this. This is actually a get method. If you didn't mention, automatically it will consider as a get method. I already said to you. Okay, now I change this to post. So now it is a post method, right? And I am going to do the same process now. I am adding 2 information, but it is showing CSRF token. Okay, actually for CSRF they are already giving one inbuilt method called CSRF token. For showing that, you need to call CSRF token. That's it. It will automatically load this. What exactly this CSRF token means? This CSRF token will prevent you from hacking techniques. For example, we are passing more the number of information, right, in post. So that time hackers can easily get the information. So this CSRF token will create one cookie information which will give up some security. So it will automatically encrypt the information. So your data will be secure using this CSRF token. This token is only visible for cookies, like which is inside the browser. So it is a kind of security purpose. So now what I am going to do is, I need to reload it. I'm adding See, it is showing another error called post, because we already gave that as a get method. So I am changing this to post. So now I change now. Now if I did the process, it is adding. So basically you can think like, why he is explaining this concept? Because while registering, we need to store the information, right? So you have to know what are the methods we have, how we can do the process. Okay, that's why I am explaining this information. So for reusing purpose, I created header, footer, and I showed you how to use the content also. Okay, so thanks for watching, guys. Please subscribe, like my channel. So thank you so much. Bye.